As Bardock and Raditz flew through Snake Way, they were intercepted by of King Kai's students. They had been sent there as backup in case things got hairy, especially with that one skipped combat. Raditz asks who this mysterious prisoner is, but Tien shakes his head, saying that King Kai seemed too afraid to answer. They could feel an immense, dark power emanating from King Yemma's place. Who in the hell was this guy? The heroes finally arrive at the checkout station, where the ghostly Ginyu Force are holding all of the Oni and spirits inside hostage. Birder and Jace were guarding the doors. Golda was pointing a pointy pillar at one of the Oni, using his telekinesis, and it looked like Rikum was trying to ease some of the spirits. On top of King Yemma's desk, grabbing onto the sweaty Yemma's necktie, was a small purple alien with horns. Bardock's stomach dropped. He instinctively yells out, "Frieza!" and fires a riot javelin towards the creature, destroying King Yemma's prized mahogany desk in the process. However, when the dusk settles, the purple monster wasn't even fazed. He flicks his tail and stares down at Bardock before chuckling. "Frieza, huh? That's the same exact thing those so-called Ginyu Forcers had called him back in the prison." The malevolent being bows courteously, revealing himself to be the notorious space pirate, Lord Chilled. The room went quiet, as Chilled said out loud that they must be trembling in fear at the mere mention of his name. Chiaotzu raises his hand, as he admits that he doesn't know who he is. The other heroes chime in, and state that they've never heard of him either. A tumbleweed flies by, as Chilled becomes angered. He refuses to be mocked in this way. He'll make sure that these ingrates never forget about him. Chilled order his men to attack, as the Ginyu Force give their salutes before charging towards the Z-Fighters. At first, it seems the Ginyu Force has the upper hand. Goldo uses his telekinesis to hold down the heroes in place. Raccoon punches Yamcha in the face, as Birder unloads a flurry of kicks towards Tien. Jace throws two crusher balls towards Bardock and Raditz. However, their gleeful laughter turns into shock as both Yamcha and Tien smirk at them. Their attack barely even fazed them. Bardock and Raditz? They didn't feel a thing. The heroes burst open their ki, which overwhelmed Goldo, breaking his concentration and telekinesis. The Z-Fighters get ready for a difficult battle. But before then, only around 35% of you guys that watch these videos are subscribed. So don't forget to click the subscribe button down below so you never miss a video. They launch their counterattack, and it proves to be too much for the Ginyu Force. Yamcha unleashes the Wolfang Fist onto Raccoon as he begins to spit out the souls that he had consumed with each hit he takes. Jace throws a roundhouse kick at Tien, and he easily catches his leg and throws him to a window. Goldo attempts to use his telekinetic powers again, but he's stopped in his tracks by Chiaotzu's own telekinesis. Birder tries to use his speed to dash towards Raditz and Bardock in order to confuse them, but Bardock sighs. This was the Ginyu Force he was so worried about? Bardock tells his son to deal with the pest as he locks eyes with Chilled. He's the real threat here, and he can't waste any more time in these small fries. Raditz nods his head, and without moving from his spot, he uses his tail to grab onto Birder's leg, slamming him into the floor. Chilled face palms. They don't make good minions like they used to anymore. Looks like if you want something done right, you have to do it yourself. Chilled lets go of King Yemma as he bolts towards Bardock. He quickly reacts in time to block the incoming attacks, as Chilled's fist connects with Bardock's arm. The resulting shockwave knocks back King Yemma, his Oni, and even Chiaotzu and the rest of the Z-Fighters. The check-in station's windows break. Bardock grits his teeth. If he hadn't reacted in time, he would have been a goner for sure. The two combatants launch a barrage of attacks at each other. They start going so fast that no one else is able to see them, not even Tien with his three eyes. Bardock has indeed become stronger in the past few months, and Chilled is nowhere near as powerful as Frieza. However, he's still a fearsome foe. He's still stronger than Bardock. It takes every ounce of concentration to not let himself be overwhelmed by the pirate's onslaught. Raditz, Tien, and Yamcha try to intervene, but they get ambushed by Golda's time stop. The entire building is shaking as a result of the battle. The ceiling starts to collapse as pillars and statues crumble around them. King Yemma warns Bardock that if the chicken station is destroyed, then there's nowhere for the dead spirits to go to. Hell and Heaven won't be able to accept any new souls, and the dead shall roam the universe. Raditz clenches his fist as the Ginyu Force begins to chuckle. They are sitting ducks now. Raccoon says that he's pretty mad now. He's ready to blow this whole stinking place up. He begins to charge up his ultimate technique, the Ultra Fighting Bomber. Goldo snorts loudly before suddenly stopping dead in his tracks. He's knocked towards the wall, and he falls unconscious. What happened? It was Chiaotzu. He wasn't caught in the time stop, so he waited for the right opportunity to strike at Goldo with a Dodonpa straight to the forehead. No longer paralyzed, the heroes make quick work of the Ginyu Force. Chilled yells at his man to get a grip. Bardock sees his opening. He tells Chilled to take this fight outside as he slams his fist onto the back of his head, sending the pirate rocketing away from the check-in station and towards Hell's Needle Mountain. Raditz tells Tien to tie up the defeated Ginyu Force as he flies after Bardock. The battle is still ongoing, but the Space Pirate is starting to gain the upper hand again. His brutal yet quick attacks were beginning to take a toll. He even used attacks Bardock knew Frieza had used, such as the Death Beam. Raditz arrives to help his father, but Bardock yells at him to get away. He is in over his head. Before Raditz could even protest, he is shot through the chest with a Death Beam. Raditz coughs up blood as he falls into the Needle Mountain. Time freezes for Bardock. He knew that if someone dies in the other world, their soul is destroyed forever. Chill chuckles. He says that no matter what era he's in, there will always be fools out there. Meanwhile, on Namek, Goku had just witnessed Krillin being killed by Frieza. Both Bardock and Goku begin to twitch. The needles on the mountain begin to shake as it seems Hell itself is trembling. A storm begins to form around the skies of Namek and Otherworld. Even the check-in station is shaking. Despite being entire realms apart, both father and son were about to unleash their power. For the first time in over 1,000 years, the Super Saiyan legend is born. Their roars echo across the cosmos as their righteous fury transcended the veil between life and death. There were now two Super Saiyans, the champion of life and the defender of death. While Frieza twitched in fear upon seeing the awesome Super Saiyan on Namek, Chilled merely looked puzzled. Golden hair? Chilled chuckled as he asked Bardock if he really thought a change of hair could possibly change his fate. He points his fingers outwards. But before he could even fire a single Death Beam, Bardock had already appeared before Chilled, grabbing his finger and in an instant snapped it like a twig. Chilled couldn't even scream as he was suddenly assaulted from all sides with unstoppable punches. These fists were flying at such speeds and intensity that fire started to form around them. The heat of these hits and Bardock's aura was starting to set the needle spikes on fire. Chilled couldn't handle the pain nor the heat. Bardock began to spin incredibly fast, performing a raging meteor move that ended with a backhanded swing that was so powerful it cracked the gem on Chilled's head. Chilled crashed into the blazing Needle Mountain beneath him. The pirate opened his eyes. His hazy vision makes out a menacing figure of Bardock slowly walking towards him as the inferno rages around him. Chilled looks in utter terror as Bardock starts to charge a ball of ki in his hand. Should he do it? Should he erase this monster? It's what he deserves for what he did to his son. His son, Raditz! Bardock stopped in his tracks and turned around. He had heard the yell. Standing before him, clutching his chest, was Raditz. His spirit hadn't been killed, just yet. Raditz yelled at his father again. He needed to stop. The battle was over. They're protectors now, not murderers or conquerors. This was their new path. They didn't have to go back to how they used to be. Bardock looked at his injured son and back at the shaking Chilled. He stared him in the eyes before letting out a mighty roar. He raised his fist. Chilled closed his eyes as Raditz yells out no. That's when Bardock grabs Chilled's hand and twists it. He was under arrest. Raditz sighs in relief before wincing in pain. Bardock smiles at his son, helping him with one hand while restraining Chilled with the other. The trio fly off to what's left of the check-in station. Although the building was severely damaged and in need of many repairs, it still stood tall. The delicate balance between life and death had been saved. Bardock, Raditz, and the other Z-Fighters tied up Chilled and the rest of the Ginyu Force in chains. Raccoon complained about how hungry he was, while Jace cried over Captain Ginyu. If only he were here, he would have led them to victory. Chilled scoffs, telling them all to shut up before they are all dropped in their new cells. Raccoon was placed in Nappa's cell as his new prison mate. Raccoon refuses to be put in a cell with a stinging Saiyan, but a quick punch to the gut by Nappa sends the brute wincing to the floor. Nappa smiles. He always wondered what it would be like to have his own lackey. Bardock and his impromptu team get praised by King Yemma and the residents of Hell. Not only that, words of their accomplishments even reached Heaven. It reaches the immortal champions of the other world, as well as the other Kais. In particular, a green-skinned man who hears rumors about Hell's new protector, a reformed Saiyan with a righteous heart and a legendary power. This sounds like it could be fun. Back in the present, Bardock shakes hands with Tien, thanking him along with Yamcha and Chiaotzu for their help. They couldn't have done it without them. Bardock nudges at Raditz, who, embarrassed, offers his thanks as well. Tien tells them to think nothing of it, saying to the pair that he and the rest of them will be returning to life in a matter of months. Yamcha asks the two Saiyans if they have anything they want to tell Goku. Raditz looks at his father, and they both chuckle. The youngest Saiyan replies that they should tell Kakarot No, Son Goku, that he has two powerful fighters in Hell waiting to fight him again. The Z fighters say their goodbyes and they head back to King Kai's planet. While the pair return to Hell, they land near the Blood Pond, next to their favorite bench. Bardock notices his son is acting a bit off. Is he nervous? He asks Raditz what's wrong. He gulps before asking his father a question. Does he think he has the potential to go Super Saiyan eventually too? Bardock laughs, before slapping Raditz on the back. Of course he could. Did he already forget the lessons his little brother taught them? With enough training, they can grow to be as strong as they want. Bardock looks around the Blood Pond as he sees the white ball spirits bouncing around peacefully. They have all the time in the world to train. They'll get stronger. That was a promise they planned on keeping. Bardock and Raditz looked up towards the clouds, excited for the next time they reunited with Goku. If you want to see more stuff like this, be sure to share, leave a like, and a comment. That really helps me out a lot. This video was done ahead of time, so I'm sorry if you became a member in the time between me making this video and it being up on YouTube. Shout out to the Super Saiyan Legend and Super Saiyan God members of the channel. Brian Skidmore, Hannah Rowan, Mateo is Lost, Cage, Sacred Saiyan, Neo Whitcomb, Sith Lord, Darko Roktonsky, Jin 1412, Obi-Wan Fun, Midnight Combatant, Fox Die, Eric Dragon, The Real Samuel Randall, Anthony Notes, and Zachary Croy. Thanks so much for your support, guys. This channel would just not be around without you all. If you want to know how to get your name shouted out in the next video, be sure to click the join button down below. Thank you for watching, guys. I know that this version of the story is a little different than what some of you guys expected, wanting Bardock to return to life and stuff, but I'm already doing that in my What If Bardock and Goku Came to Earth Together series. So I wanted to do this a little different, explore other parts of the Dragon universe. I hope that you've enjoyed that. As always, if you have any ideas for what ifs, leave them in the comments down below. And be sure to check out my other Dragon Ball What If stories. There's a little something for everyone. Also, I gotta say thank you to Professor Chimp for writing this video. We spitballed a lot of ideas back and forth, but this was mostly his doing. It's a lot of help because I'm actually not at home and able to make videos right now, so all the videos you're seeing through the month of June were pretty much all done ahead of time. Anyways, guys, I really hope you enjoyed, and until we meet again, see ya!
Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to SmugStick, unless you want to be destroyed.
Lord Beerus, that's hardly fair. But also, don't forget to click the bell icon to get notified when he uploads new videos.